Hello viewers, welcome to NBC News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news and details. Within 24 hours, the crime branch team has succeeded in catching the criminals firing on Vaishnav Kapil yesterday at Kalameshwar. The murderer's purpose was to kill both husband and wife. According to the information, Ganesh is the head of the Meshram gang and also included in the list of notorious criminals in the city. A few days ago at Pratap Nagar, Ganesh tried to kill his opponent, criminal Golu Malia. In order to avenge this, an attempt was made to kill Ganesh by firing. Due to the possibility of gang war in both the gangs, the police have arrested all the culprits after taking strict action. Among the arrest accused, the main accused Nikhil alias Golu, Lal Singh Malie, Farooq Khan Shoving Makode, along with his partner Himanshu Ravi, Shankar Chandrakar, Mohammed Haider, Parvez Ansari, Ankit Ramchandra Durve, Chandrakant Suresh Shinde, Abhishek Mangeshgiri, Ankit Tulsiram Nimche, Gaurav Ajay Pille, all are Nagpur residents. During the mayor's public awareness yatra, some shops in Gopal Nagar Pratapnagar area were found violating even odd rules. The mayor instructed the shopkeepers to impose on spot fines. On his instructions, the corporation's nuisance investigation team took action. Mayor Sandeep Joshi directed to impose on spot fine on such shopkeepers as soon as it was noticed that many shopkeepers were not following the rules even though the lockdown was relaxed and the mission began again across Nagpur. He warned that strict action would be taken if any more rules were broken. Mayor Sandeep Joshi visited the market and the Lakshminagar zone on foot to ensure that traders and consumers in the market area follow the rules. Prakash Bhoyer, chairman of Lakshminagar zone, Dilip Dive, deputy speaker, Pramod Dabhane, assistant commissioner of Lakshminagar zone, Raju Bhivgade, the mayor started his yatra from Mati Chowk. He visited Gopalnagar, Pratapnagar, Khamla, Devnagar and other areas and appealed to follow the guidelines given by the government regarding COVID-19. He also appealed to follow the rules of even and odd dates. He informed the shopkeepers about the rules, urging them to wear masks and observe physical distance. Follow the rules or face action, he warned. The Railway Police Force has arrested a person who black-marketed railway tickets from the office in the name of tours and travels to serve the citizens of the city. Data of old tickets worth 34,850 rupees has been found in the mobile seized from the accused. A case under the Railway Act has been registered against the accused. The above action has been taken under the guidance of Divisional Railway Manager Ashutosh Pandey. According to the information, the RPF had received secret information about this black marketing. On that basis, the RPF, with the help of Dandoli Police, raided the office of Tours and Travels on Vardhan Road. Accused Dinesh Ramesh Pal, aged about 40 years, resident of Vardhan Road, inquired about ticket black marketing. When the accused did not provide any information, the police took him to the RPF police station. There it was revealed that blacklisting of 31 railway tickets was done after extracting data from his mobile with the help of computer experts. The special thing is that the accused does not even have any license from IRCTC. After the action, the accused has confessed to selling the tickets for a commission of 200 to 300 rupees per ticket. The number of corona infected patients is increasing day by day. Now the corona has reached every compound of the city as well. Corona has been knocked into the fire department office. The officer of the fire brigade has been found corona infected, because of which there is a stir in the fire department. Now the further procedure is going on. The PUBG game killed another child. The name of the deceased child is Rajveer Narendra Thakur. He committed suicide by hanging himself. This incident took place on Monday in a Narmada apartment of Yogendra Nagar. He was in the 6th standard. Rajveer's father, Narendra Thakur, is employed in the crime branch. According to the information, a few days before, Rajveer started online study. For that, his father, Narendra, gave him a mobile and tab. After finishing his studies, he used to play PUBG. On Sunday night, he played PUBG on his mobile till 1 a.m. He then failed to reach the final level. In the meantime, he tried the curtain to the window. He committed suicide by putting a pillow over his mouth. On Monday morning, after knowing all the incidents, Narendra immediately removed the noose around his neck with the help of his brother. Rajveer was admitted to Alexis Hospital, where doctors examined and declared Rajveer dead. Police have speculated that he committed suicide due to the madness of PUBG. Gettigadan police have registered an accidental death in the case and are investigating further. In view of the increasing infection of coronavirus, two COVID testing vans were given to the office of the divisional commissioner by the late Prabhatai Ojas Rajasthan. The COVID testing van was inaugurated by Maharashtra Legislative Assembly Speaker Nana Patole. Other workers were present during this time along with Cabinet Minister Nitin Rao. Dr. Arbat, who designed the van, described the speciality of the van. He said that the doctors who will test the corona patient in it will not have any kind of infection. Dr. Arbat said that a van filled with a positive pressure is going to control the temperature. HEPA filter has been used in it, which is used in ICU. The most important thing is that due to the small size of the van, it is very easy to take it to any containment zone. That's all for this bulletin. For more news updates from city and around, please stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Stay healthy.